Radio station in the land. Mr. Kevin Olivachi, good afternoon to you, Kevin.
Good afternoon to the entire Soul League. Once we have life, we gotta be doing good, man. That's the most important factor. So,
for sure.
Giving thanks for the one that suffered the pain and go through the pain to bring forth male and female.
That's a man
and girl. Become man and woman.
Yes, yes.
Of tomorrow.
Yes, being up all the mothers one time.
Yes, man. And in the house with me here today, I just want to send a special shout out to my son, Imani, and not forget my daughter, Kimora.
Definitely.
And to the mothers of my children.
For sure, for sure. Gotta touch up on the youth every time. Well, we got in our house this afternoon. We got our guest here, the Captain D.
Thank you.
Well, Billy, this is a surprise. I know to people. I said, hey, by the way, who you got on this afternoon?
Yeah, well, it's only Billy.
It's
only Billy. I'm a true Swaligian.
It's a pleasure to have you. Another patriot.
Yeah, man, big time. Big
time. Production,
You know, teenagers become ill talk about this afternoon. But I got to give you props, really, on having the balls, the goinas, to have a platform like what we're doing here every afternoon. Because
but it's all about education, eh?
Yes.
I think that we're so behind, and some of us are so discouraged. So, you know, what you guys are doing is keeping people to know that we're still alive. We ain't dead yet. The fat lady is still yet. We ain't got dead.
To some people, when they listen to the program, it sounds on the edge. It sounds like, what them fellas, them, how they could say something like that. But not knowing, we are in our rights, what we are doing.
No, but we're not talking against people, no. We're talking for people.
For people.
You see, and that's the difference people need to pick up. You're not talking against anybody, you're talking for your people.
Yes.
So if you feel bad and think we're talking against you, then you got a problem. Because we're talking against you. We're talking about bettering our country. And the reason for that is because your children intend to live here, my children, their grandchildren. So if you don't prepare that part, then there will be nothing left.
Yes.
You know, there would be nothing left. Most parents who would send their children abroad to study would love to see their children come back home to work.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want to see my grandchildren on vacation. Mm-hmm. I would like to enjoy my grandchildren every day.
Okay.
You know, as my parents enjoyed their grandchildren, I don't want to know that I gotta get ready to go next month. My grandchildren coming in the gun for 12 months and I got to see them. No. Mm-hmm. So I have to prepare that path.
So in order to do that, the country that will be able to welcome you.
Definitely. And you need to prepare. If we remain being this nation of importers, then what's going to happen? You know, what's going to happen to... Because at some point, you cannot accommodate everybody.
Exactly.
You know, if I went to the United States to study, and at some point, the United States tells us it's time for you to go. You know, go back home. No, you got what you came for. Go back home, because I got to make space for the generation coming. It seems I'm told one thing. It's a generation who are coming. And if you don't prepare for them, then it's a whole different ballgame. So we always try to tell people, we're not talking against people, we're talking for people. And if you really love St. Martin, wherever somebody is from, then they would understand what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
They would join this program and saying, look, I am not from here, but I would like to help you build what you're building, because it is about you.
Exactly.
You know, it's about you. So it's a simple thing to understand, right?
Yeah.
You know, some people, and what happens, the more they keep us apart is the better. For certain high powers, the more they break us up and make us feel fight against each other, is better for them.
Yeah. But then still, they should realize, especially those who are from here, it is detrimental for them also, because their children,
they're going to live here too.
They're going
to
live here.
And this is what I always say, help me to help you. Because if I am strong, then I can't help nobody else.
Yeah.
I need to get you to help me so that I could help you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's the way life is. If you go in a country and you're making it, the only way when you already settled down, you could send for your family.
Mm-hmm.
You can't send for your family if you're just reaching, you're just looking for a job and you ain't set up yet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so help me help you.
Exactly.
You know? So I always tell people, I don't talk against people, I just talk for people.
Yeah. And so once again, big up on the opportunity for the people to get edification from the platform that we're using.
Yeah. But you know, we have changed, and everybody, you guys say it all the time, SOS have managed to change a lot of concept in radio.
Yeah.
You know, you see, and people don't understand, we call it our kind of name, but it's about building a nation.
Exactly.
It's about building a nation. If you listen to radio station anywhere in the world, any talk show, if you go to France and you listen to a talk show, being friends.
They
talk about the economy, they talk about the people of France, they talk about how friends are getting out of debt. So they talk about them.
Mm-hmm.
So there's nothing wrong with talking about me.
That's what
you know. Everybody talk about himself at some point.
Justifiable. Exactly.
But the respect of self, for me, that is most important, because with that aspect, then others can respect you.
Yeah.
But for what we have the role that we have played lately, you know, as Samaritan and host and everybody, we have not demanded that respect. And, you know, they see it fit that people just walk over us and it has become...
I don't think nobody, I wouldn't say people walking over us. And the guy said this again, I'll say it all the time. You can't walk over me in my mother's house or in my house. And today we don't need politicians per se in this country. We need leaders.
Mm-hmm.
We need strong people. Politician is the administrative world of another country. A leader holds down the country. A true leader holds down this country. Politician is paperwork. The pay is for paperwork. Administration. Leader stands up for his country, and this is what is really missing, you see, because everybody could be a politician, but who really could be a leader? That's the difference, because a leader is going to go and say, I'm ready to die for my country. Then you stand up as a leader, you see, and that's the difference. That and at some point, that's what St. Martin is looking for. St. Martin is looking for a true leader, instead of looking for a real politician.
Exactly.
I may actually just like your opinion about on this. Conscious America. But to my opinion, there's a conscious America, but there's a country within the conscious America. That's where I'm coming from. But basically that our administration, our governing body, which is local, which is supposed to be St. Martin, not administrating or not governing in the favor of St. Martin.
No, they can't govern in the favor of St. Martin. Listen, they got the trap all set. And I keep saying this, especially on this side, we've been set up to fail, you know. We've been set up to fail. And when you look at the bigger countries telling you, okay, I'm going to give you your country, but you can't have immigration, you can't have this, you can't have that. So you're setting me up to fail, because the most important things that I need for my survival, you're still holding it.
Yeah.
If you're telling me that I don't have control on immigration, I cannot leave from here and go on the dark side, I don't have foreign affairs, everything is still you, then you set me up to fail.
And
today we're 6 months in a new with a new government, we can't find a budget, right?
Mm-hmm.
You go in France today and you hear France have a big deficit, but you're not gonna find a lot of, you hear what Paris doing. I was still getting the money she needs, but all of what relates to France still surviving.
Mm-hmm.
So you're setting me up so much to pay. I tell you, I can't pay you, but you're telling me, I give you money that you got to pay me. You got to pay me back.
Mm-hmm.
So you're setting us up to fail. And this is what happened in countries in Martin, the same thing. You get this big name, ministers, prime minister, you get this big, so we jump on the name, because, hey, I'm a minister. But then, if you're a minister, and you can't, and you're a minister of justice, and you can't make sure that a fellow leave your country, then you ain't no minister of justice.
But then, but
But then how come so many of our St. Martin people went in there and they can't come up? Honestly, and tell us, listen, this thing here, what for?
It got something called preparation, according to me. You know, and if you know you gonna build your house next year, you got to start to save money.
Yeah.
You got to start to save money. You got to go around. You got to start to say, Kevin, how much you gonna sell blocks? Go by this. And then you have an estimate. You need to start to put things together for when the time come. Mm-hmm. But we didn't put things together. We started to build a house, and now today now the house stops. So we like, oh God, where I get the money from? Because you didn't study the path out. We need a plan, actually, for St. Martin, Kevin. You see, we working on a daily basis. You're going in the apartment, building your work, you're going home. We need people to sit down and say, look, what's going to become a St. Martin 50 years from now? Make a plan. Mm-hmm. If you don't have a plan, then you're planning to fail. You got to have a plan to tell yourself, I'm making a plan that, you know, 50 years from now, this is what St. Martin is going to look like. You see the same way we saw a plan in front of the in the newspaper yesterday?
Yeah, for the
how you can make a plan to determine where your country is heading in the next, so like that every year you don't have to run look for money because your plan is falling in place. But it's about who, a famous thing. It's about being in the spotlight. It's not country above self.
You know another thing that I don't understand, especially with the French side, the government set up. If you check the president, the vice president, and most of them have their own job still, but they still want to be in government. So how can you focus on doing St. Martin work when you have to go do your 8 hours work?
That's a whole thing, you know. That's one of the serious problems. You have time where the government would give you time off your job, but no, this today. It is a full-time job. When we said that during the campaign.
You mean government?
Yeah, that's a full-time
it's
job.
Supposed to be.
It's a full-time job. It is a full-time job.
But we noticed that our
you could go work and come in today. You don't come in. No, that's not the way. That you cannot build a country like that. This is a full-time job. If you're in government, you got to mind you got to think about the people business. But you can't be running and I tell you, okay, wait, I can't come to the meeting now because it's just not about that.
And the salary they're getting is enough for them not to have to work.
Definitely.
So I
definitely.
Understand.
Definitely. And as much as is the system is set up so funny. You have a senator, you have a deputy, but the big say is in France. Okay. So you're always in this France thing and you're deciding. You're getting caught up in all the work we're going to be doing in France.
The final say is still in France.
It's over there. But then, you know, and we're not going to function unless we get a mini parliament. This country correctly.
Talking about parliament, there's a few of the media is leaving the island next week.
Yeah, and this is an initiative that the deputy took, and he invited all the local media to France. Very good initiative.
That's very good.
Very good initiative.
First time it ever happened, huh?
Yeah, well, for first time we have a deputy too.
Okay.
So, you know, but what I'm saying is, I'm the person that tells people, once the election for me is over, that's it. I don't care what definitely. It is a great movie made. He managed to negotiate with Air France, get some good prices on tickets.
Mm-hmm.
He invited everybody from the media who wanted to go, and on Monday he's going to be having lunch in the parliament for the local media, and just after lunch around 3 o'clock where he works
in France.
Mm-hmm. How he is, where he works, how he operates. So the local media is going to get a chance to see mm-hmm. how it functions.
Mm-hmm.
You see? And I really commend the deputy for that. I think it's a great, great, great move. Because we could stay here and we could always see Parliament, we see it on TV.
Yes, yes.
But here now, you're going to be there, you're going to be, you know, it's going to be a real thing. We're going to see what is happening. So I really commend him for that.
So when you are going to Parliament of the it's going to be like they're going to be making decisions and
no, it's not going to be no session. I don't think it's going to be a session actually happening. I would think it's because he said he's going to have lunch, and then if there's a session going on, probably you're going to stay up and you could see. But he wants to show us basically where he is at and how
things operate. So you can get a good view of what happened in Parliament. And I think that is, I really commend him for that.
Yeah.
I really commend him for that. And this is why you see, this is why in all differences, this is why you need different ideas in politics.
Yes.
Because then ideas could spread, you know, it could be done differently.
Yes.
And that is important.
It would have been nice if he could invite y'all when I have lobbyists.
Yeah, but he said he's going to do it again, eh? He said he's going to do it again whenever it's needed, and maybe that's one of the time when you're going to get a chance to see things in action.
And stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. But, you know, it's pretty much what we see on TV, basically, when you see the senators and the deputies get up and they're dipping in their cars.
Mm-hmm.
But he says he's going to do it again, and you're going to be able to see exactly, you know, how it rolls. And I think it's a super thing. I really congratulate him. And you know, and SOS is going to be part of that. And I think it's a super thing that he did.
So very interesting.
Yeah.
Is it maybe an idea after this informative introduction that you all be getting? Maybe that the deputy works with a team, like a media team, every time that he travels.
Yeah, but you see, the thing with him is the media team.
Yeah,
but media team is not in his budget. He got to negotiate airline ticket with Air France, which he managed to do. But the media team, when he say media team, you see, France already tell you they're there. Their media is there. So he don't really can't move in a media team because it has to be in his budget. And I'm pretty sure that is not in his budget because we know all what the deputy comes with assistant. But having a media team really is not because they, and again, in France, more, we, once the news is in France, we've seen it on TV, that's it for them. That's the news, that's it. You see? But this particular trip, I'm pretty sure he's going to organize more. It's very important for us at this stage.
How much days you all going to miss?
Well, it's one day this is going to happen, but he says if anybody would like to stay longer could stay, but normally it's scheduled to come back on the 19th. But if anybody wants to stay over, then, you know, you could stay over. But like I said, you know, it's going to give us a better, and, you know, what's good about this, if this continue, you could, so all of us will get a little idea of what is happening over there, and I think it is so interesting.
It is interesting,
and you know, who knows?
You know how much radio stations is taking part?
No, I don't really know how much is going. I think he said this morning with me on the air that two or three media said that, you know, thank him, but he said that it was a little late, you know, for them probably to prepare. So, you know, but I again, you know. They're probably going to go in the future, you know. But it's a great, great move by the deputy.
The reason why I ask the question is because information is a very powerful source, especially the movement of a nation or the development of a nation. So, I mean, I know, like I said, it's not part of his budget, and maybe because we are in a deficit right now, but I think maybe they should consider having that media team along when we are in any session that they can inform the people about.
You see, but in his cabinet, he already have that. In his attaché parlementaire, he have people who's in charge of sending what happened to the media. You see? But to take the media all the time, that's the difference. But he have people in his cabinet, the deputy would have people in his cabinet who's going to write a newspaper and everything you're going to know. If he's on TV a day in assembly, you could see him on TV too, because we catch those same channels. You see? So that and that's the way they're going to look at that. Whatever the deputy or the senator do, they relate back to the population easily, so you get back that news quick.
But don't they have the chance to edit that information before it reaches somebody? Saying that
not necessarily.
If you go live, then you have the news information right there at hand.
No, but he
they cannot give, you know, play.
No, because the deputy or the senator, when they write, they write what happened. So there's no really misleading on what is happening. Yeah. Because it is a worldwide information that is transmitted directly. So it's nothing that is really hiding, you know. But we're on that trip, X-ray, and that is important. We accepted that quick because we think that it's gonna help build
yeah.
all
also the station and the relation and with the deputy, and then you have a better understanding also of the person. You know, like I say, election is over and it's time to build a nation.
You see, what is something so interesting about it is, especially for the media, how the media have put the interest into the whole political arena this last.
Oh yeah, definitely.
You know, it will give the radio stations now a wider understanding of how French politics functions.
And even here on the Dutch side, you know, now and then the local medias all should be invited, and I know that they're there, but get a good chance to be always part of the sessions in Parliament. Mm-hmm. I see today a thing in the newspaper where the UP is criticizing William Martin for having some type of meeting, closed door meeting, you know, and I think our meeting should be open. It's the people's business. You know, it's the people's business, so our meeting should be open so that the people could know exactly what is going on.
The transparency in government is always a better way to go, because nobody wants to say that you say what you didn't say.
Exactly. So it's there, you say it, it's open, and if you say it, if you make a mistake, correct it there one time quick, because that's the way it's going to go.
Yeah.
You know, that's how people's going to really get it. But I'm a true Swahili like you guys, and I we are alive, Kevin. Trust me, like you said, we are alive, and things have to change. It got to get better.
You know, I gotta say, Daniel Gibbs is showing some positive movement.
Yeah, and I don't look at this as no media bribe, eh?
No, it's not.
It's not a media bribe. It is a good thing that he's doing.
Yeah,
that is, you know, it is good. It is good. It is healthy for the country. Because if I could come back with pure criticism, you could come back with pure criticism. Some Kevin could come back with pure positive thing. But everybody's gonna have their opinion now to say, well, this is what I think really. If you see anything that is needed, so you get a chance to talk.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get a chance to talk. I think we're even gonna, the media is even gonna get a chance to question or interview the Minister of Overseas Department, which is Mr. Victor Nyerere.
Mm-hmm.
So all of this is really important.
Yes.
We're gonna bring back some of it live, but you know, the time difference is so different.
Mm-hmm.
But we're gonna try bring back some of what the information, you know, live. If Parliament permit us to use phone in the facility, we're gonna be able to bring some of the interviews maybe with the deputy himself, they're alive.
I definitely got to commend our deputy for that move, because if he continues like that, which means he involving St. Martin in his movements,
and
that's what we need. We had too much of leaders before who would go out and do things, and you don't know what to do.
Yeah,
you know, and you need to know that you're doing something.
It's the people's business. You need, you know, if you don't want to be there, come out, give up your seat, get out. But it's the people's business.
Yeah. Otherwise,
you're elected, once you won an election, it's the people's business you're dealing with.
Yeah, of course, because it's the people who put you there.
That's it.
So
primarily, it's also the results for the people, and not just the show. You know, because you can do all of that as decorative, but primarily, you know, like I said, the people get brainwashed. You know, they get hypnotized, but when now, in the long run, when we supposed to get the effect, feel the effects of it or the results, we ain't seeing anything. And I hope, like I said, that in the future now that we do get effective results.
Yeah, but you know, I'll be honest with you, I'll be very honest, I'm not too optimistic about results coming from the Senate or Parliament in favor of St. Martin. There's a battle going on over there, you know. And remember, over there you're meeting, is this battle with party business, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And today we know that the socialist is in control of what is happening. So if the senators in the right and the deputies in the right, hardly today you're going to see anything happen. I'm not saying they're not going to try or they're not going to battle, but it's going to be rough. So being what we need, for me right now, we need result locally. We need results locally. The deputy or the senator going to defend their part, but we need results locally.
Hear this. I wanted to ask you this question earlier, but now that we're talking, it is the right moment, I think. For me, way too long that seeing the present situation and the ills that St. Martin is facing, okay, generally, that we know basically what the problem is. We have a heart problem. to have a heart surgery, so we need to deal with a heart specialist. But we're going by the dentist to solve our problem.
Yeah.
I wouldn't.
The problem is finding the right source is difficult because you go to the heart specialist, but when you check your heart, he tell you, but you know your heart was sick, you know. He tell you got headache too. When you get by the next doctor, tell you, but you got toothache too. And this is the ill we got today. If we had only a heart problem, then we could solve it. But we got a lot of little problems that are getting huge and huge and huge. And one of the biggest problems in St. Martin today is that we cannot take care of everybody. Because this is one of the main concerns, and a lot of people are telling you after a while, you anything that is too full with overflow,
definitely.
Anything that is too full with overflow, because you're not making any type of preservation. Because we need to know that, and there's so many analysis. In a year, you have 700 children that are born in a country. You got to predict that 4 years after they're going in school, then they're gonna be in this school. Then they gotta. So you gotta make a projection on everything. Mm-hmm. And remember, a fellow who 50 years now, he ain't gonna die at 51. He could live up to 100. So you gotta have another projection on this fellow that is 50 years now. You gotta provide for him. The country need to settle down, structurize itself. Mm-hmm. And this is what we is missing. The structure of St. Martin is not there. We're running everything on a daily basis. We run it just like we open a store every day. You make money, and when you don't make money, you count your cash in the night, and you check your profit, and boom, 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 and it's finished.
Yeah.
We need to bypass that. We need to look and structureize a country. If you got so many kids that's born in a hospital, you need to know that. Follow those all the way down, because they're going to become adult.
Yeah, yeah.
They're going to become adult. They got to go to school. They got to eat. Everything will happen.
Yeah.
And I know if we get a good structure right now in this country and a good grasp on the country. First of all, we don't even know how much people is in the country. We don't know who's in the country. You can't run a country if you don't know who's in the country.
Yeah, like the school just opened up there themselves, they know how much.
Exactly. If you
students have come.
Exactly. If you in your household, and you know, and our particular analyst, which is Stowe, said it right. How many of us as St. Martiners say, look, I'm making so much per month, you got to multiply it by 12. You know that, okay, let's say I'm making 12,000 euro for the year. Okay, this 12,000 euro, you know how much your light bill is. We don't do that. We just spend money like we're crazy.
Yeah.
We don't, hardly you would find us sitting, and that's what we're supposed to do.
Yeah, that's how
we're supposed to know that if I'm making 12,000 euro for the year, I can't spend 15.
Mm.
So my light bill is so much, my water bill is so much. If I buy this big time car, then I go over my board. So by the time the year end, I'm in a deficit.
Yeah.
And if you keep running in deficit all the time, after 10 years, you're in a big deficit.
Yeah, big deficit.
Because the money, you're always in this deficit.
Yeah.
So we need to really take our time and structure-wise. You would be surprised to see that other nations in this country have a budget, you know. They run their household with a budget.
Yeah.
Because they manage to live here, pay rent, eat, drink, party here, and still send money home in the country.
Mm.
And we who live in here, but before the month finish, we ain't got no money.
Yeah.
So we're not on a budget. We need to come back on that pathway. Hey, if I'm making so much money, I really can, you know, actually let's party tonight, but I can't party, but I believe because if I go over this,
my budget tight. Yeah.
But no, we can still party, and then we're going to look to see where the money coming from.
Yeah.
And then we're going to look at other people. We need a budget.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot run over your budget. You know, and I know a lot of people always say, buy my account in the red. How could your account always be in the red? It's because you're not controlling your budget. And that's what we need to do. The first thing you need to do is multiply your salary by 12. I'm making 15,000 euro a year. All right, this is going to go here, this is going to go there, this is for this, and how much more liability is there. And if you realize that a certain month your liability gone up or down, hey, I talk to the children, look, I put not too much of light.
Yes.
We need to bring this back down. The water bill, I talk too much on the phone, bring it down.
Mm-hmm.
And if you come, and how do we don't do that?
We don't do that.
I don't do it, I know.
No.
Because I feel, you feel sometimes that whatever the phone bill is, you're going to find the money.
Yeah.
You get slapped with a phone, a light bill, and I know people get, you get a water bill of 800 euro. You know how much water you have to use? So you have to tell yourself, no,
no, I ain't dealing with this no more. This water bill got to be down to $200 almost nothing.
Yeah. Or there's a leak. There's a leak somewhere.
Or there's a leak. Or there's a leak. You know,
but business.
I know that we need to come back to those basics.
Yes.
We need to come back to those basics because things is hard, you know.
Yeah.
Things is rough for a lot of people in this country.
Yeah.
You know.
And basically, all the students every year that we have traveling is about maybe generally 200, 160, between 150, 200, and what are we providing, like what Billy was just explaining, in the long run for
when
they come back, because the present structure, right, is what he said, strangers permanently establish the market.
Yeah.
It is not strangers come to play an effective role, and thereafter, when our local that went to provide themselves with the necessary ingredients to function in such a department or whatever level, that then the strangers will pack up his bundle and then go back. But right now, we are on a strangers permanently establishment in Samantha. That is how the structure is in Samantha. And that is very detrimental in the sense of, like you said, what will we have to provide? What are our children going to come home to?
Yeah.
Because when they look at the
but you see, government is who make that space, you know. Government job is to keep that space open. You send a certain amount of students during the year, but a certain amount come back.
Mm-hmm.
So you gotta keep providing.
Yeah.
And today, if you look at it carefully today in St. Martin, nobody can employ nobody. We have one employer on a friend side today is a collectivity. And they right now can't employ people no more.
Mm-hmm.
So look at the danger that we're in.
Wow.
You got a business that you can't employ nobody because the system don't permit you to employ. You're not making the money to employ nobody. And we have one employer. When the collectivity stop employing people because she's on the verge now of that set,
mm-hmm.
Who's going to employ people?
Mm-hmm.
And then what's happening? The government, since the government come up with these plans, okay, do these short-term contract. 6 months. After 6 months, you're gone.
Mm-hmm.
So if you on a contract for 6 months, you will never be able to prosper in your life.
Yeah.
You can't buy a car. You can't rent an apartment. You basically can't do nothing because the bank is going to say, but you only got a job for 6 months.
Yeah.
So I can't give you a loan for 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
So the country is going to keep cramping itself. Okay, we need to be able to expand. We need to get creative. And in most instances now, maybe we need to see St. Martin's opening even a little business. But you could open a business, but if there's no buyer, you're still in trouble. You're still in trouble. And one of the big things that, and I can't blame, and I told you guys this the other day, I can't blame the government now or that. No, we got to blame government way back and back and back. When we had a bunch of strangers in the country shopping at local businesses. So you got to say, Jackie, these strangers was contributing to our economy because they were going to the local shops and shopping.
Yeah.
When government turned on and started to give these people permit to open shops.
Yeah.
So when you give me a St. Martin a permit to open a shop in New York, but you're going to tell all the St. Martins to go shop, but I'm going to man the moon. I got my own shop.
Mm-hmm.
So you direct the strangers from keeping our economy afloat, and you send them to their
own people.
To their own people.
Yeah.
And this happened in every sector.
Yeah.
Restaurant, supermarket, and mechanic, you name it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So you take the money what we were making, having the economy floating, and you direct it to one to there now.
Yeah, yeah.
So you would see the stranger prospering because if you got 15,000 Haitian in St. Martin, you got 10 Haitian shop. The Haitian got shot by the Haitian.
Yeah.
You really can't blame them.
Of course.
If you got a Jamaican who got a mechanic, he's a good mechanic. When a Jamaican guy begins, he's going by that mechanic.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to see that mechanic from Jamaica prospering. You say, but how come we making the money? It's because the resources that we had to hold on to our economy, we take our economy and we spread it.
Yeah.
Okay? Because business today. If this was the case, still we St. Martinus alone had this type of business, everybody would have to shop by the St. Martinus. Economy would keep floating. Mm-hmm. You see? But you give it away.
Yeah.
So this is mistakes that were made from in the past.
5 years ago.
Yeah, this is we reaping, and that's why we have to stop the clock at some point. We need a good reflection group, and we need to start back this business. Because we made too many mistakes. We give away our wealth.
Yeah.
We give away everything we have. We give away our beaches. Why St. Martin's even the beaches doing the same thing with restaurants today? We give away the beaches. Everything we had to make money, we give it away.
Yeah. Everything.
Everything. So when you give, because the same people that have their business today, they would be shopping by you.
Exactly.
They would be shopping by you.
They're eating by your restaurant.
Today, if some wholesalers deciding important ketchup in St. Martin's, people can't eat them with ketchup because they have a sealed deal contract with the big boys.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? These are businesses that a country that say, look, you could import rice, but we want part of this. St. Martin's got to be this. Because we can't give away the soul, you alone to bring rice. Because then that means the day you decide you want to bring the rice, then we can't eat the rice.
Right.
So what happened? We give away too much of our wealth. And if we had hold on to a lot of that, you would have seen businesses prospering.
Of course.
You go back 20 years ago, our little business in St. Martin was doing good. You had a little restaurant, you were doing good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Even down to the chicken leg business, the barbecue business, we don't even own that no more. And there was a little fast making money for the St. Martin. Huh? We give away all of that.
Everything.
No, so make an analysis on that and see. You would see exactly what happened to St. Martin. St. Martin being hurt, you know, bad administration from years ago. Because at some point people realize that, hey, in politics they got deal, I'm going to get rich and forget about the people. When the time come back, I'm go back to them, they can vote for me anyhow. And that was it.
Yeah.
So that what actually basically happened to the people of St. Martin, because there's a handful that still manipulate the key economical pillars of St. Martin, where the same shade is basically what we get the economy to have to go through them to be able to
come back.
Sustain
to come back.
The port,
yeah.
A different aspect of gasoline, you know, and pharmaceutical products. It's a few locally, some own these exclusive rights,
and
share it with the St. Martin, you know?
Yeah, and we fail even in our schools, because the teachers that we had back then wasn't telling our children, you could be a lawyer, you could be a doctor. No, they say, what you say?
Seriously.
We're in tourism business, man. You got to learn to make a bed, you got to learn to be a bartender.
Mm-hmm.
No, we never direct our kids and tell them. I tell my children all the time, you ain't going to be no bartender, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't going to be no bartender, you know. You ain't going to make up no. And I refuse. That's what I tell people in this country. Speak adult language to your children. Don't baby talk your child all the time. You got to be this. You could be this.
Ownership.
But what we did, the teachers back then tell the children, wow, I got tourism country. I got working hotels and all. So some people end up, hey, we tourism ain't going there, so we working in. Look what happened to tourism today. So tourism had failed today. If you see tomorrow, Cuba really dropping open her doors, you will see how fast tourism going to disappear in St. Martin.
Yeah.
Because people waiting for Cuba to say, no longer communist, anybody could come.
Yeah.
You're going to see how fast things are going to happen. We fail, and we still have a chance today to bring that back.
We can bring it back. And I got to inject that. That's why we want to take this platform to another level, where we, every first Sunday, we come together and have these kind of conversations.
Yeah. And that's why I commend Soldier. You know, Soldier's like, I still believe in Soldier. People don't know. Soldier took his time, and I have to find my time to go back to school.
Yeah.
Ain't way too late for me. We can go back to school. Soldier put himself back in the bench, went back to school, you know. And the only way we could educate our children, but is we too, we got to be educated.
Yeah.
You know, you can't educate your child if you ain't educated. paid, or you ain't got the time to check for nothing. We got university where it takes some time. You could start at basic English. You could start at, you know, in business. You'd be surprised to see the skills you have now that you didn't have when you was in school. You see, because now you went through life.
Yeah.
And I always said, now is a chance for a lot of adults and marginals to go back to school and surprise themselves.
Well, believe we gotta leave it there. A very interesting topic, but we gotta stop until Monday. We back again.
You're gonna be back on Monday because you're gonna hold on talking point. I'll be calling in on talking point from Paris, Gospel. I could tell you basically how the day has been with the deputy and rolling. And for sure, when I come back, then I'll be able to come back on another 5 o'clock talk with you and tell. But there's hope in this country. There's hope. There's a lot of hope. There's a lot of good things that's gonna happen. But we need to start to move.
Definitely.
We need to start to really move. And people who love St. Martin, we will be able to identify them because they're gonna come in.
Yeah, they're gonna come in.
They're gonna come in.
And this is what we need. This is why we need these kind of talks and platforms for the people. Because and people outside listening, you know.
Not only that, too, but
all over the world.
And you know, you'd be surprised that sooner or later you're gonna have to interview Jamaica and you gotta make some interview with because you gotta see how these people feel too.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm pretty sure that a lot of them does say, you know, these guys are right. You know, they're defending. Because if you hear how Jamaican get on in the country defending Jamaica, there's nothing wrong in that.
Exactly.
So you're going to have to get, we're going to have to get the ideas of how other people think, how other people feel, and how other people see us, and how we see them, in order to harmonize this country and make it a great country.
Exactly.
Most definitely. I would say thanks for the words of encouragement and the words of motivation.
Yeah.
The people of St. Martin.
All the time. Yeah. And you do a good job and you got to believe that. As I know, you and the rest of the media definitely going to do a good job for St. Martin and make St. Martin proud, definitely. With that, we're out of here until Monday, God's willing. I'll be on Talking Point Monday morning and also Monday afternoon on the 5 o'clock talk at 6. You know, have yourself a blessed weekend. God love you.
Love you too.
God.